I spoke a little bit about astrology and how it's not science, and it has to do with wondering if things that happen on Earth have to do with the position of objects in the sky, like stars and planets and moons and that kind of thing. Well, let me just tell you a few more things about it here. The program that I have in front of you that I'm showing is called Stellarium. Hope you can follow my mouse cursor up there. And you can get yourself a copy if you want. It's stellarium.org. It's a wonderful program that allows you to look around at the whole solar system. You can travel between planets. But anyway, I have it brought up here just sort of to show you the night sky. So the big S means we're looking to the south. And I can sort of scroll around a bit and do something like this. And it gives me a few names of some stars up here, like Sirius and Rigel and some things in here. So what will happen is, suppose we were 4,000 years ago trying to understand the night sky, what we might have started to do would be to associate the stars with various images. And so if I turn on the so-called constellation art in this program here, you can see what ancient civilizations might have been talking about. Like this grouping of stars here might have led to a rabbit, this one over here sort of like a dog, and some of these images and constellations even exist today. Like, for example, let me just pull this down just a bit here and center on it here. This big constellation that looks like a hunter sort of killing an animal here is called Orion the Hunter, for obvious reasons. And as I mentioned in an earlier video about becoming a better camper, this Orion constellation is something that, you know, you should be familiar with. It's a winter constellation, and this big star Betelgeuse, which is as large as our entire solar system, is sort of at the armpit. There's this belt right there, and then if you can sort of look in here where this fuzzy stuff is here, that's where new solar systems and planets are being formed as we speak. Rigel is always a star in the foot, and so it doesn't surprise me then that maybe ancient civilizations might have started to form images from the star patterns. Again, if I just turn them off, you see all these little dots, and you might just start connecting them with images, whether it's to help you to remember or to understand the night sky. And so this is what they did, and there's just a bunch of images for things like that, and you can just see how elaborate it got here. Here's the two twins here, so-called, and Pollux is one of the stars and the two twins there, and it just goes on and on, and a lot of these ancient stories still exist today in terms of just helping astronomers in the science refer to different constellations. Like the Orion constellation would definitely be something that is said in modern astronomy, but I want to emphasize again that astrology is not science, but I'm just telling you, I just understand where it comes from. Okay, and the second thing I wanted to tell you then was a lot of people use astronomy. So I'm showing you the text here that my wife received from her friend Andrea. They've known each other for 25 years, since high school or so. I don't know what the conversation was about, but they're talking about Julia here. I heard a little bit from Julia about his rules. Maybe it's the Aquarian in me. So you see, Andrea believes heavily in astrology, and she uses it in her everyday life sort of to understand people and their interactions. And so my point is that I don't mean to bash astronomy. I definitely understand where it comes from, but I know it's something that probably a lot of you might be interested in and look into, and that's fine. Go with it. Whatever makes you happy, whatever makes you comfortable. But let's just keep in mind that is not science. We don't look to astrology to explain things in astronomy or what's happening in the sky. So we'll just sort of leave it out of science. We'll leave it out of this class. But I hope then that that gives you sort of a complete answer to question number one, in particular, the difference between astronomy, astrophysics, and astrology. Astronomy, of course, is motion. Astrophysics is when you start adding some physical properties to things. Astrology is what I just spoke about. And of course, the last one, astronomology, that's not even a word. That's just meant to be a joke, but it doesn't actually mean anything.